Every Wednesday night, an elite team of FBI agents tackle some of the most twisted crimes on the TV series Criminal Minds, right here on CBS. The show has now aired more than 250 episodes, and each week, fans follow the life and career of Special Agent J.J. Giroux, and she's the FBI genius. She can handle a gun and doesn't back down from a challenge. If you love Criminal Minds as much as we do here on The Good Morning Show, you'll be happy to know the actress who portrays J.J., Miss A.J. Cook, is on the couch with us this morning. Today, she's taking on a less daring challenge later on in Martinsville. You're a grand marshal for the NASCAR race that's happening later on today. Good morning to you, by the way. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Let's talk a little bit about the triad in general and how you feel about being here so far.
It's been a whirlwind. I mean, we're here for like less than 24 hours, so I'm trying to get it all in. Just to let you know how it's gone so far, I decided to throw out on Twitter, hey, gonna be in Greensboro for the night. What suggestions? And all these suggestions came flying in. So, yeah, we've had a really cool local experience so far.
That's really, really cool. You're, of course, here in North Carolina because of the NASCAR race that's coming up. Mm-hmm. NASCAR is huge here in North Carolina. And today you have the honor of telling drivers the most famous words in NASCAR. Tell us a little bit about giving the start command. Have you done this before?
No, I haven't. This is all new to me. So I just hope I don't screw it up. It's just drivers, start your engine.
That's
it? I think I got it. Yeah, I think I got it. Watch me screw it up now. Yeah, no, I'm so looking forward to it. It's such famous, iconic words to say. So,
are you a NASCAR fan?
I like driving fast in my car. So NASCAR is a whole new experience for me, and I've heard so much about it, and I can't wait to just feel the energy in the arena. And is that what you guys call it, NASCAR, or an arena? I don't know.
I think the racetrack.
Yeah. The track, yes.
And you'll be hanging out with one of the drivers later on today.
Yeah.
How did that all happen?
I have no idea. No,
they just set it up and
up. I'm literally along for the ride, but I can't wait. I'm really interested to talk to some of the drivers to find out what goes on in that car while they're going in circles. No, it's all fascinating to me. I can't wait.
Yeah, it sounds like you're going to be learning a lot while you're there today.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so of course, a lot of people watching this morning, they want to know more about your role on Criminal Minds. You've played JJ for 11 seasons now. Can you believe that?
No, I can't. It's so crazy how time flies when you're having fun.
Well, in that time, we've seen JJ evolve as a character. She started out as the FBI's liaison with the media and local police agencies, and later on, JJ became a full-time profiler with the behavioral analysis unit. So what have you learned in those years about just investigating crimes and just law enforcement in general?
I've learned more than I cared to learn, unfortunately. Yeah, when you play a profiler for that long, you pick up certain terms and you just understand the human psyche a little bit. And we go to some dark places, and I've had to learn things that I never really wanted to learn. But at the same time, it's made me much more of an aware person in life in general, and I'm a mom, so it's frightening. There's a lot of mentally sick people that need help, and I love when we ask the question, nature versus nurture, the whole, you know, what came first, the chicken or the egg type of a deal. Like, and especially now with everything going on in the world, there's so many sad things happening every day, and I think people want to figure out the root of it. Where is it all coming from? And that's sort of what we do on the show. We try to get into the head of the serial killers and figure out their next move before they know what it is.
Yeah. Well, you were doing a great job on that show, and a lot of viewers were really excited for you to be here in the triad. Uh-huh. They sent in some questions. We want to get to some of the viewer questions this morning. they're really easy. Caitlin, for example, wants to know more about, you know, what to expect from the season finale. Do you have any scoops that you can tell us? I know you can't reveal too much.
Yeah. You know, this has been such a crazy season. I mean, spoiler, I'm not going to give any spoiler for what's to come, but what has aired, we've seen Mr. Shamar Moore, Derek Morgan leave the show. So there's been a lot of goodbyes, but we've also had Padgett Brewster back. We've been able to say hi to Emily Prentice again. So it's been a really great season for the fans. And what I will say about the finale is that the writers constantly blow me away with ways to keep the show fresh, because I'm thinking we're going into this 12th season. How do we keep doing this? How do we keep, you know, the viewers coming back? And the storyline they've come up with, which will lead us into season 12, is so clever, and our true fans are gonna love it, because it's something that we're recalling, and the fans love it when we do that. So there's a storm coming. There is a storm coming. Yeah.
That's a good enough scoop. Do you ever know what's coming up before it happens, or do you get your script and then?
Yeah, you know, this year's sort of been a blur. I had a baby this year, so
congratulations.
I'm not as on top of it as I have been in the seasons past. I'm lucky if I can just, you know, look at my lines before I go on set. But yeah, we have a real, really open relationship with the writers and our showrunners and everything. So they're really good at keeping us in the loop. I've just not been in the loop this year. I am sleep deprived.
All right, so you're only in Greensboro. I guess once you leave the set here, you're heading over to Martinsville. And we saw on Twitter that you enjoyed your time here. Yeah. You went to Hop's Burger Bar.
I did.
How was that?
It was good. Like I said, I went on Twitter, and that was I got a lot of suggestions for Hop's. So we were like, me and my husband are burger connoisseurs, so we went there. And then we also crashed a divorce party.
I heard about that. A viewer told us.
Yeah. It was so fun. The fact that she sent it to me, I was like, we gotta go. Like, we gotta show up. So we just showed up and said hi, because I had to get up really early this morning. And we bought them all a round of shots, and we're like, peace.
But they were all so pictures. Sweet. You guys took pictures together, and she really, really loved that. Posted it on our Facebook page, and that's
how
we found out.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being here, AJ Cook.
Thank
we
you.
Appreciate your time, and good luck
thank
at
you.
The race this afternoon.
Woo.
It's 6:57 right now. We'll be right back.